Yes, start.
Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Dr. Shatabdi Giri from Pediatric Cardiology Fellow from Kokilaben Dhirubhai Ambani Hospital, Mumbai. And I'll be presenting a case report on an adult with corrected transpiration of great arteries and advanced heart failure who was successfully bridged to cardiac transplantation using long-term homeldenone therapy. As we all know, the CTGA with intact septum is often diagnosed late. Heart failure due to systemic AV valve regurg and diminished systemic ventricular function is the most common eventuality in uncorrected patients. Cardiac transplant then remains the only therapeutic option for this subset. Until the availability of a suitable organ, these patients require to be bridged with ventricular assist devices, which, however, is not an option in resource-limited settings like ours. We report a case of a 37-year-old CTGA with advanced heart failure who was successfully bridged to heart transplant with long-term homeldenone therapy. Well, our patient presented to us with acute heart failure and pulmonary edema at the age of 37 years. He was first diagnosed with CTGA at 35 years of age in view of exertional dyspnea. He had previous three episodes of heart failure requiring hospitalization. At presentation in our institute, he had breathlessness at rest, NYHA class 4, with dry cough and pedal edema. He was already on two anti-failure medications since the last 2 years, although the doses were inappropriate. He was immediately admitted to ICU and was stabilized with non-invasive ventilation, inotropes such as adrenaline and meldenone, and IV diuretics. He had an ICU stay for 3 days. His chest X-ray showed cardiomegaly with bilateral pulmonary congestion and left pleural effusion. His ECG showed heart rate of 100 per minute in sinus rhythm. 2D echo at our institute showed CTGA with dilated LA with severe AV valve regurg and severe ventricular systolic dysfunction. He had end organ dysfunction during presentation, which gradually improved over a period of time. Following stabilization, he continued to be inotrope dependent, Intermax stage 3. Trial of meldenone weaning was given twice, but was not successful. LVAD support would not be offered due to resource and financial limitations. Financial support for him was generated through NGOs and public fundraiser, and patient was then listed for cardiac transplantation. But in view of prolonged transplant waitlist, he was discharged home with meldenone infusion at 0.4 mcg per kg per minute and other anti-failure medications. Now, a few points about the home meldenone therapy. Meldenone was constituted in 5% dextrose and it was delivered through a double lumen catheter inserted in the brachial vein, and a battery-operated portable infusion pump was utilized to deliver the medication. The total cost of the infusion pump, along with 1 month of meldenone and disposable, was around 35,000 rupees. Instructions were provided regarding loading of the pump, care of the line, storage of medication, and practice sessions were undertaken prior to discharge. Instruction sheet were given to the patient regarding home monitoring of the heart failure and home meldenone instructions. As I have just given the image of the instruction sheet. Now, about home monitoring, the heart failure staff nurse at our institute would have a telephonic conversation once a week and inquire regarding danger signs such as excessive weight gain, pedal edema, palpitations, urine output. He was asked to visit a family physician once every fortnight for BP and weight charting, and he was followed up every month here at our institute. Weekly peak line dressings and disposable changes every day, and infusion preparations were done daily. He was maintained on meldenone infusion at 0.35 mcg per kg per minute. There were no episodes of line-related infection or fever. However, PICC line was electively changed after 3 months. Over the next 6 months, he had no further episode of heart failure, and there was a definite improvement in functional class and 6-minute walk test. He had stable end organ function and NT-proBNP remained normal. A suitable organ became available 6 months following listing. Well, our donor was a 45-year-old male of blood group B positive and weighing 70 kg, and successful cardiac transplant was undertaken. The ischemic time for the transplant was 320 minutes. He had a stormy post-op period. He had primary graft dysfunction with severe cardiac dysfunction, LVEF for 15%, requiring ECMO support for 5 days, pacing for 7 days. Gradually, the ventricular function improved and he was discharged on 17th post-op day in sinus rhythm. So moving over to discussion, our patient with uncorrected CTG and advanced heart failure had multiple prior ICU admissions and transplant remained the only option. Lack of donor organs and arranging financial assistance for transplant meant a long waitlist time with a high risk for mortality. Lee et al. Have published the data of 150 adults who were listed for transplant and were successfully bridged using outpatient long-term home milrinone. So to conclude, until the easy availability of mechanical assist devices at affordable cost for patients with advanced heart failure, long-term milrinone can be tried. Outpatient chronic milrinone therapy allows patients to thrive at home, decrease hospital stays, and stabilize prior to transplant. Thank you. Am I audible?